Hi guys, it's me Karen and welcome back to my channel. If you're new, welcome. Today I'm going to do part two of the page I'm working on in Wildflower Folk by Christine Karen. We're working on the wizard here. So we're going to do his hat today and probably a little bit of the robe here. And we're going to start off with all these colors I have on the side. Mostly all the browns and a couple of greens and of course the cream color that I'm going to use as a base. So I'm going to put it down as base color first on the hat and probably some of the robe area here. So we're just going to lightly put this color down. This is going to be our highlight color. It's probably going to be covered up pretty much, but it'll be there just in case. I'm going to go down in here. We're not going to bring it up to the black area with that. It'll just be covered in different color. I'm using kind of the side of the pencil, this whole piece here, just to get a soft, no scratchy lines coloration in there. Okay. I'm going to go over these stars. I'm not going to worry about them. If I want to put them in, I'll put them in later, but not while I'm coloring the hat. If they disappear, that's fine with me. They can just be a nice little faded area there. Now on his jacket, I'm going to, or cape, or cloak, whatever you want to call it. I'm going to put some of that color there, and in this line here. This is like a sash, probably that comes down. So I'm just going to run it right through there. And bring that color down. We will darken it with a dark gray if I can find the dark gray. Oh, we'll just go in with the black. Follow that line. Probably would be up here a little further. We'll go right about there. Follow that line, comes right about in here. So there we go. It'll be across there. Fill that up. Okay, and the cuffs. Okay, that should work. And I'm going to get you down a little closer. Okay, we're going to go in with some green gold here. And we're going to kind of put in some of these shadows. I'm going to follow the lines a little bit and extend them. Leaving this hill as the lightest color and the valleys down here in dark. Okay, and then down here on the arms. The neck up here. Okay, now we're going to go in with a dark color. What do we got here? I pulled out everything, so we'll go in with the burnt umber. It's nice and dark. We're going to go back in to where these areas are and pull a little of that dark in there. And if you remember, we put the cream down in here, and that's going to lighten it automatically all by itself using the same exact pressure that we are using everywhere else. Which is a very light pressure. Okay, I'm going to turn it a little bit so I can get the angle better. Thank you. just putting the tip down to give it a little darker color in there. A little feather fluff there I don't want to color into. And we'll just keep going up here. We're going to put a lot of layers on here, so keep that in mind. Be darkening the edges around here and making sure our little wrinkles are in the hat. It's got to be the most boring part, but it's a big hat. I'm going to turn the book just so I can get the lines going the right way. Look, everything on my desk. Okay. Bring that same color down here on the sash. Just darken up some of those lines. just so I don't forget what color I'm using down there. We're going to bring in burnt sienna now, a little bit of the red tone. Okay, another color. Lots of colors. Okay, we're going to go in with walnut brown now. Thank you. turn the book a little bit so I can get these angles right. Dark on the edge. Bring that color in. Any shadows need to be added dark underneath each one of these. Ties for the hat here. Closing that gap between the two colors. Just going to keep turning this so I can get the right angle. Then we get another color. Black. We're going to go underneath the hat here and darken this. Still using a light pressure on the pencil. Darker just in this little nook here. I don't know if you can see that, sorry. It's closest to my face, so it's probably not even in the camera. things. Bing, 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 bang. Sorry. Not talking much. My voice is going, so. Always a fun thing. Weather's changed here, so. It's like, yay, last week, 50s at the high. At night, it was still in the 30s. Yeah, this week, for some reason, it decided to jump up to the 70s. Overnight. I mean, it wasn't even like, you know. A little situation, it just boom. This is the burnt sienna just coming down here because I didn't get that very dark down there, so we're going to switch in between that and the burnt umber. Just to darken that little area. And leave that for a little bit. Okay, we're going to bring in some brown ochre. Boom. Then let's see, we've got some raw umber. I'm going to bring in a little green now. Why not? This is the olive green yellowish. Using that side of the pencil. Then we have chrome green opaque. Then we will add in a little bit of pine green, and I may regret this one, but I'm going to put it in anyway. Then go back in with the other greens. What do I have here? The green yellowish. Can you see the side of the head? I don't know if you can. Excuse me, green gold, which was, I believe, our first color. Or second color. Then we're going to bring back in a brown. Just have to pick one. Van Dyke brown. It'll cover just enough of that green, but leave it as a tone in the hat. Okay, we're going to take a Caran d'Ache blender, and then we're just going to blend the whole thing together. We're just going to use it lightly. Go in the direction you want all that to blend into. And that gives us our hat, for the most part. And pull some of that color down over his face, just a little bit, if it will come down. It's all over my fingers, so I don't see why it wouldn't. Just to give him a little shadow there. Okay. Wipe that off. Go around the outside area with the eraser just to make sure you have clean lines here. That I didn't get too much of that color out in this area. Don't forget we have feather fluff there, that's why it's like that. There we go. A duster would be better than smearing it with my hands. Okay, then we're going to take the black in and just outline some of these lines. Sorry, I don't need to mean the thing all over the place, but we're just going to deepen some of these. Okay, well, I have a very shiny hat here, so I'm going to have to turn off the lights and get a picture of it. And I think that'll be it for today. That was pretty intense there. I don't know if I'm quite done with it. But for right now, it's a little red I wanted to add in there just to give it a little bit more, yeah, no, tonage there. Brighten it up a little. Okay, well, I'm going to stop and I will see you in the next one. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section down below. And I will get to them as soon as I can, and I will see you in the next one. I hope you all have a wonderful day. And like I said, I'll leave the pencils in the description box, and I will also take a picture at the end so you don't see it with all the glare and the bright lights. Thanks for watching, guys. Take care.